Michael Kaplan was one of the most superhuman creators on this project. On an ongoing basis throughout the entire movie, again and again and again and again and again, he would reveal these designs that felt really unlike anything you'd seen elsewhere. There was something about all of these costumes that just, to a character, felt absolutely right.
What I knew was important was to give people the same world that they remembered. And so we added a lot more patina, a lot more detail, taking the origins and then adding 30 years of change was how we went about creating this new world.
It didn't really hit me that I was in Star Wars until I walked in to meet Michael Kaplan, who was showing me the costume designs.
He was by far the most difficult character to nail down. I think it had to do with the helmet, and JJ was our barometer. He looked at hundreds of sketches, and he said, it's very close to what I'm looking for, but keep working at it, keep working at it.
There's more investment we put in this than probably any other element, and so it took a lot of attempts before it came down to this. I think the guys did a really good job.
JJ always wanted him to have a cape and a hood.
What they had created was so good, I had to try to live up to it.
There were so many elements and individuals responsible for Rey's look. When we first see her, JJ wanted her introduction to be a bit mysterious. We don't know if she's a man or a woman or an alien. The materials, I thought, had to be very desert-like, protective in a way, and yet I knew that it would be beautiful if she was in the desert and it was windy, for there to be something to be blowing and moving in the wind.
For me, it was so incredible. The whole thing of seeing how a film is made, is especially with Michael, with this film, is like the costumes really reflect the settings. It works so well.
We just arrived at this sum total of light colors and femininity and strange goggles. I said to one of our concept artists that we need goggles for Rey, and I was looking through the sketches he had done, and I said, this is amazing. And he said, they're actually stormtrooper lenses that she might have found because she is a scavenger. And I just love the idea.
Everything's supposed to look like Rey has put it together herself. Everything she's got fits her. But obviously with incredible people doing that.
Everything is there for a reason. As it turns out, it is a very beautiful image that all these pieces together make up. Initially, when we had the issue of Finn starting out as a stormtrooper, I said to JJ, well, what's he going to be in? The armor is thick enough where he could actually have on anything. And JJ said, yeah, that would make sense. He said, except he's going to be dressed all in black. And I said, yeah, but he's in the desert, so he could get very, very dusty, so then we don't see our hero in totally black clothes for the whole movie. So that seemed to work, where the pants and shirt got dustier, and once he puts the jacket on, it's somehow a complete costume change.
Finn's jacket, there are different stages of Finn's aging levels, because John wears it in the baking sun of the scavenger planet, goes through a lot of action. So each time he goes through this action, it's reflected a little bit more within the jacket.
In Harrison's case, we knew who Han Solo was. His personality hadn't changed. And also Harrison looks great. And so we used that as a starting point and then changed it enough where everything he wears all feel like Han Solo. We actually had more clothes for him than we used in the movie, but once he put on the short leather jacket, we lost a few other costumes because of it.
Working with Michael Kaplan was great fun. I'm very interested in costume and how that represents character and how it looks and moves and feels. And I was a real pain in the butt. But I'm happy with the detail and the energy that was put into the new costume.
May the Force be with you.
Well, Carrie, we started out doing more gowns for her throughout the movie, like what she wears at the end of the film, but they seemed impractical, and JJ asked if there was anything that would feel like it made more sense in her day-to-day at the military base, and so I came up with the jumpsuit, and he loved it.
Every time we would go to a set, people would show up wearing costumes that were just staggeringly beautifully done. Whether it was the villagers on Jakku or the people at the outpost where you meet Rey, or whether it was the gangs that, you know, Han Solo's confronted by, or all the characters at Maz's castle, or the new stormtrooper uniforms. Again, just a testament to Michael Kaplan and his seemingly endless creative ability.
When I got here and started meeting people, it was an embarrassment of riches. I mean, there's so much talent over here. I'm just so happy with the people I've worked with and their brilliance and how great it's reflected on me. And it's been an amazing experience.